Okay, it's time for questions.
Bring it on. Yeah, let's bring questions from our viewers. This is Heather, who says, with the horrible ongoing ISIS attacks, I was wondering what you think Jesus would say about letting Syrian refugees into America. Is it more important to protect our country from evil or to try to reach out and save those who do not know him?
By nature, I am compassionate. And if I see a family that is fleeing oppression, I would say, let's put our arms around them and help them. That's my own personal. But from a policy standpoint, the truth is these evil people have infiltrated the refugee hordes. And like one of them up in Paris was a man who had come in through the Macedonian corridor up into Europe. And he was, I guess, Syrian. I don't know what he was. But nevertheless, he was one of those refugees, and he brought mayhem. So I do think a country's got to be vigilant. But my heart, you ask me, my heart is to help the poor. And if I saw a family that's fleeing the oppression and the war in Syria, I would open my heart and say, let's take them in. But policymakers may disagree. All right.
Okay, this is Richard, who says, is it wrong to say, holy smokes? I hope not.
the Brits say, I'd bloody well do this.
Yeah, but that's supposed to be a bad word.
It is the blood of Christ. That's what.
Really?
Yes, that's what it means. And we have many things, and, you know, holy smokes is just one way of talking. But gosh, golly, and these other things all come out of God. So, you know, it's really tough because in our slang and in our patois, if I could use that term, we have all these terms. We don't realize the significance of it. Mm-hmm. But I think we better be careful we don't blaspheme. All right?
This is Christine, who says, there's no doubt that ISIS must be stopped, but we went into Iraq with shock and awe and left it a breeding ground for ISIS. How can we know that doing the same thing with ISIS won't make martyrs and raise up an even deadlier terrorist organization? Oh. Good question.
You know, there's an old saying that used to be quoted, don't strike the king unless you kill him.
Yeah.
And you strike somebody that's powerful, and they'll come back to try to hurt you unless he's put out of the way. We struck Iraq. We struck it wrong. It was incredibly botched. We put a guy named Bremner in there who didn't know what he was doing. He mishandled the Iraqi army. And you've got the Sunni-Shia conflict going on. I think this ISIS thing is totally different from that, because what's happening is the Sunnis were being oppressed by the Shias, and the Shias were trying to gain ascendancy and so forth. But it's not the same thing exactly.